In the world of acting, we have four levels of actors. The basic amateurs, the professionals, the elite, and the god-level king of actors. And today's video is going to be focused on one of the very few god-level actors to ever grace the silver screens, Katharine Hepburn. Here's a fun fact. Did you know that Katharine holds the record for the highest number of Academy Awards won? Stay tuned to find out more. But before we go on, do not forget to subscribe to this channel so you do not miss out on more amazing content like this one. Done? Let's go! Katharine Houghton Hepburn was born in Hartford, Connecticut on May 12, 1907 to Dr. Thomas Hepburn, a urologist, and Katharine Houghton, a campaigner for the legalization of birth control and a key figure in the battle of women's suffrage in Connecticut. Her parents made six figures, so she enjoyed a luxurious life. Growing up in a luxurious Hartford mansion, the family was a strong, fearless family who preached confidence and courage to air one's opinion and thus encouraged their daughter to speak her mind, develop her mind fully, and exercise her body to bring out her full potential. She was also taught about important political and social issues and was told to express her liberal opinions freely. She knew a lot more social and political issues than most of her mates. She grew up to be fiercely independent with a strong-spirited personality, with a strong passion for women's rights. She was often seen accompanying her mother to demonstrations, and she described her parents as remarkable due to their progressive views. As a child, Katharine wanted to be a boy so bad because she thought boys have all the fun. So she cut her hair and behaved like a tomboy, calling herself Jimmy. Her father was an avid supporter of active and athletic children, so she had the chance to take part in activities that mostly only boys participated in, like wrestling, diving, horse riding, tennis, swimming, running, diving, and even golf. She found golf extra exciting and took daily lessons, and developed herself a pro. She was so adept that she entered the Connecticut Women's Golf Championship, reaching the semifinals. Did you also know she took ice-cold baths every morning because she believed the bitterer the medicine, the better it was for you? Okay, now that's a new one. She was a lover of movies too, and she always went to see one every Saturday. As a child, she would put on plays and perform for her family, friends, and neighbors to raise money for the tribal members of the Navajo Nation. She was really close to her family, especially her brother, mainly because they were just 2 years apart, and they did almost everything together, since she was Jimmy at the time. In March 1921, she lost her brother to what her father described as a stunt gone wrong. This left her devastated, and transformed her from a vibrant, brilliant, and outspoken girl to a very shy and withdrawn girl. She was so shy she couldn't go to school or stay around girls her own age, so she was largely homeschooled. She attended Bryn Mawr College, mainly because her mother wanted her to, but later began to like it, and when she graduated, she was completely happy she made the choice. It was during her time in college that she decided she wanted to become an actress, and appeared in several college productions. In her senior year, she played the lead role in the production of The Woman in the Moon, and positive comments she got on her work cleared any doubts about her future career as an athlete. She traveled to Baltimore to meet the American film producer Edwin H. Knopf, who owned and managed a successful theater company. Her eagerness and determination earned her a small role in the movie The Tsarina. Her performance in this movie was excellent, and the reviews earned her a part in the following week's show. But that wasn't such a huge success, as she was criticized for her tiny voice. So she left Baltimore to work on her voice, with a voice tutor. She was given her first lead role in The Big Pond, just 4 weeks into her career, after the previous lead actress was fired. But she wasn't ready for such a huge responsibility and flopped. She was later fired. The former lead actress was rehired. Undeterred, she continued auditioning and was given a role in the Arthur Hopkins These Days. But reviews were equally poor, so she left the screens and went on to marry. She planned on leaving the theater entirely, and she began to miss the work and returned immediately. She was hired in several other movies, but was described to have no talent. Her breakthrough was The Warrior's Husband, where her eagerness and aggressive energy came in really handy. She gained really good reviews in this movie, and that opened doors to several other movies, and the awards started trickling in. By 1993, she was a respected actress, but not with numerous setbacks in form of horrible reviews and poor movie sales. She also began to have problems with the press, who described her as rude and provocative, and even denied fans autographs, which earned her the nickname Katharine of Arrogance. She had a really long career with various ups and downs, but the ups surely do cancel the downs out. After she retired from the silver screens with 4 Academy Awards from 12 nominations, making her the only person to hold such a record. She was known for being extremely private about her life and would not provide answers about her life in public. She stayed away from the celebrity lifestyle, as she described it, as being tedious and superficial. She avoided public places, even restaurants, and was reported to have wrestled a camera from a photographer who took a picture without her permission. Despite her secretive lifestyle, she was worth quite a number, and she sure did enjoy the luxury that came with it. She, however, became more open as she aged and even granted a 2-hour-long interview on the Dick Cavett Show in 1973. Did you know that Hepburn loved to walk around barefooted? I'm sure she's not the only one. She was married once to Ludlow Ogden Smith, a businessman she had met at college. 6 years later, they were ready to get a divorce because Hepburn dedicated more time to her career than the marriage. She started an affair with Leland Hayward, who proposed to her, but she rejected it because she liked being alone and single. She also made a decision not to have any children, stating that, "I would have been a terrible mother because I'm basically a very selfish human being." After her last screen appearance, her health began to deteriorate and was hospitalized in March 1993 due to exhaustion. She had several bouts of pneumonia and showed some signs of dementia. On June 29, 2003, she died from a cardiac arrest at the age of 96. And that is where we draw the curtains on today's video. Let us know your thoughts in the comment section below and leave a like on this video. Do not forget to subscribe too, so you do not miss out on any of our amazing content.